Hey all, my name is Apurva and welcome back to Vedisified. In our previous video, I showed you my travel from US to India and discussed about all the necessary documents and forms you have to fill if you're traveling during these COVID times. I was here in Mumbai for a month to spend time with my parents, and I'm glad that I took the risk to fly during these difficult times to see them. My flight was via UK both the times, but with this new COVID strain, my return flight was cancelled, and so I had to book a new one via France. I asked you guys on Instagram if I should vlog my travel, and almost everyone voted yes. So here you have it. But before we move further, please subscribe to our channel and also hit the bell icon so that you will be notified every time we upload a new video. There is a new COVID variant found in UK in the mid-December, and I was one of the passengers that flew from UK to India in that same period. And so I was constantly getting calls from TMC where they asked me to submit my COVID test reports as they were tracking down people who might have contracted this new variant of COVID. Thankfully, nothing happened to me and I was safe. But soon after that, government cancelled all the flights to and from UK, and I had no option but to book a new flight. There are a very limited number of flights being operated to and from India right now via the air bubble arrangement, and most of them are full and very costly. So it was very difficult for me to find a flight at the last moment. But thankfully I found one via Paris. However, I did not get a flight to Indianapolis where I live. I got it until Chicago. So currently my route is Mumbai to Paris, Paris to Atlanta, and Atlanta to Chicago. My US immigration will happen in Atlanta, and from Chicago I will have to drive down 3 hours to Indianapolis. So if you're traveling, I will recommend you to book a direct flight or be flexible while booking your tickets. I arrived at the Mumbai airport 3 hours before the departure. Since currently there is no web check-in available and it takes a lot of time to get the boarding pass along with all the new formalities like showing them your COVID negative test report, filling out different kinds of forms, etc. At the Mumbai airport, there were hardly 8 to 10 international flights operational when I went, and so the airport looked so deserted. Like, I have never seen Mumbai airport so empty. Many food and shopping outlets were also closed, and honestly it was quite depressing sight. But because there are not many flights operating currently, the security checks and immigration happened very quick. I did my COVID test 24 hours before my flight from Mumbai, and so I had the negative reports with me to show at the counter while getting my boarding pass. Now, I had a PDF copy of the report in my phone, but the airport authorities needed the physical copy. Eventually, they did print out a copy for me, but when you are traveling, just keep in mind to carry a physical copy if possible, so that it saves you some time at the check-in counter. For my flight, 2 check-in bags and 2 carry-on bags were allowed, but because the flight was full, they offered me complimentary check-in for my 3rd bag, which I was going to carry in the flight with me, and I saw they were doing this to many passengers. So I quickly transferred all the fragile items from that bag to my carry-on. So if this happens to you, make sure you don't have anything important or any fragile items in that bag from the beginning itself, so you don't have to do this shifting at the last moment. And also make sure to carry an extra TSA log for the 3rd bag just in case. So currently I'm at the Paris airport waiting for my connecting flight to Atlanta. Compared to Mumbai airport, this one is not that deserted. I'm in the lounge area right now having my Starbucks coffee, so that's why I'm allowed to remove my mask, and that's why I decided to shoot here. So yeah, I think I have an hour where the boarding for my flight to Atlanta will begin. You might already know this, that we are not allowed to carry water or any liquid items more than 100 ml in the flight. So what I do is I carry an empty water bottle with me and fill it up at these water fountains, and so that way I don't have to buy any drinks. Of course, they give water in the flight, but during each security check before the boarding, they trash any water bottle you are carrying. So this trick helps me save some money and is very convenient. I am now waiting for my flight to Chicago. I am done with the US immigration, and since Atlanta is my port of entry, my immigration happened here. And I have a layover of 3 hours. I always make sure that I have enough spare time for my immigration. And in fact, this time, because there are not many flights, my immigration went very quick. The officer asked me to submit my I-20, my passport, and asked me where I'm coming from, what course I am doing, where I'm heading to, and if I'm carrying any prohibited food items. Usually they give customs declaration form to fill, but surprisingly they didn't give any this time. So after clearing immigration, I went ahead and collected my bags. I had to then again check in my bags for my flight to Chicago, as this one is a domestic flight. Remember, you have to collect your bags and recheck in at your port of entry. With respect to showing any COVID reports, I told you that the authorities at Mumbai Airport printed out my COVID report for me. And then later, during my flight to Paris, they gave us public health passenger locator form to fill. This one is for the France government to help track passengers in the case of COVID. Apart from that, at no point I was asked to show my COVID negative reports. So after 32 hours of journey, I reached my home safe and sound. The journey from Atlanta to Chicago was smooth and there were no other formalities. I collected my bags again at Chicago Airport and drove to Indianapolis. I was jet lagged and tired for a day, but I'm back to myself again. I did a COVID test upon arrival at my university just to make sure, and the result came negative. So to conclude, as expected, the travel during this COVID time was hectic with a lot of testing and forms to fill. But if you take enough precautions and try to avoid contact with people as much as possible, then it is still doable. Also, you should travel only if it is necessary. We hope this video is helpful and we will come up with more useful content very soon. Please like, share and subscribe to our channel. Until next time, take care. Bye-bye.